Now let's apply Ampere's law in integral form to just a line of current. Let's say that my current is 7 amps going in the z direction, and I would like to find the magnetic field that's circulating around it. So there's the magnetic field I want to find. On the left-hand side, the closed contour that I'm going to be doing is the phi contour. We can tell that two ways. One, we can just look at it, and we can see that the contour is going in the phi direction. The other thing that we could do is we could see that dz is equal to 0 and that dr is equal to 0 on this contour, and then we could look at table 3-1 and we could see that the only contour that is left is the phi contour, and that is an r d phi contour. So when we dot that with the magnetic field, the general form of my magnetic field is going to be hr in the r direction plus h phi in the phi direction plus hz in the z direction, that's in cylindrical coordinates. When I dot it, the only term that's going to be non-zero is going to be my h phi term. Then these two will dot to 1, and I need to do my integral as phi goes from 0 to 2 pi. So the r h phi is going to come outside, and my r is going to come outside, so I will have h phi r and then phi from 0 to 2 pi, which is going to give me 2 pi r h phi. Remember we said that any time you do a cylindrical integration, the left-hand side integral is always going to be the same, so we've essentially done all the left-hand side integrals that you're going to need to see. Now in this case, what is r? R is simply r. It's the radius where we want to find the magnetic field. So we've done our left-hand side integral. Now let's look at our right-hand side. We want to know how much current is enclosed by this radius r. Assuming that r is anything larger than 0 and that I is on the center, is in the center like this. See, here's my r, there's my h, and here's my current coming out. I can see that the total current that's enclosed is I, my 7 amps in the z direction. So my integral of h dot dl is just going to be I, which is 7 amps. So, and actually, I need to point out that that's not actually a vector. This is a scalar value, and it is the total magnitude of the current that's enclosed. So let's erase that just so we don't confuse you. So this is going to be 2 pi r h phi is equal to 7 amps. So equating both sides, h phi is 7 divided by 2 pi r, and that's going to be given in amps per meter.